Remove the fusing unit from the copier and place it on a clean flat surface. Remove the four screws from the top case and remove it. It is best to lift the right side first, and then slightly shift and lift the left side. Find the small pin on the right and carefully remove it. Slide the fuser exit guide to the right and remove it. Remove the two screws and remove the guide fusing exit left. Do not remove the center screw. After removing the four screws, you will be able to dismantle the fusing cover lower. Get rid of fuser hooks easily. Now we have a little more work ahead of us. Disconnect the plugs of thermistors, thermostats, and lamps. Remove all the screws that I remove. Remove the two springs. Remove the securing clip and remove the exit roller. Remove the three screws from the metal mount. Remove the two screws from the sleeve unit and dismantle the sleeve unit. This is what a typical used pressure roller looks like. In my opinion, mark the places where the screws were inserted to avoid problems. Remove the retaining ring from both sides of the pressure roller. Dismantle the ball bearing and take out the pressure roller. If the ball bearings are worn out, or you damage them during disassembly, I suggest installing new ones.
In our online store, you will find all the necessary parts for photocopiers. Every day we add new products and take hundreds of photos. Our expert technical department selects only the best products, all for your convenience and shopping experience.
Check out our offer, if you want, of course. Prepare new lower pressure roller and ball bearings. Disassemble the gear pressure roller, ball bearing, and gear pressure roller exit. Install the gear on the new pressure roller and use specialized grease under the bearing. You will find a link to the grease in the video description. Remember that this is very important. Before installing the new pressure roller, it is necessary to remove the thermistors. If you skip this step, you may bend or destroy the thermistors. I recommend doing this procedure because it only takes one screw.
Kate is right, you should do it.
Reinstall the retaining rings, thermistors, and fusing entrance guide plate. It's time to replace the fuser fixing film in the salve unit. Remove the two springs from the stripper plate. You have probably already noticed that there is no heating foil in my sleeve unit. The foil broke off and completely came out of the sleeve unit. After dismantling the separator, do not forget to remove the holders. We will remove the side mounting of the heat lamp, but only on one side. Such damage to the oil pad forces us to replace this element with a new one. Remove the lamp mount. Dismantle bushing of fuser fixing film.
Yes, this tool can be very useful.
Prepare a new oil pad and apply new oil to its surface. Then wait 10 minutes for the oil to absorb. Throw the damaged oil pad into the trash and replace it with a new one. Prepare a new fuser fixing film. Carefully slide the new fuser fixing film onto the lamp section. Reinstall the holders, separating plate, and springs. Reinstall the sleeve unit. Reinstall the cable base and reconnect all plugs. To reset SE error 544 or 545, it is necessary to install PicoFuse. Screw on the side protection and install the lower case. Reinstall the exit guides and upper cover. Now you can reinstall the fusing unit to your photocopier.